base of the pole makes a little canyon out into the button grass.
With no features.
We've
got a few other bits just past Balfour. We'll have to look up and find out what is. The road improved a lot after Lindsay River. This is the end of the Tarkine Road. Lots and lots of rocks covered with this rust, sort of like anything. It's like over at Fishinoe, but it's on quite young rock.
I'm going up.
Well, we'll come out here and up there. And then probably up there.
You just come all the way up from down here.
This is a forestry logging area in Tarkine. And all this is regen after clear fall of paper for the Japanese pulp mills. We're getting a bit of mad traffic now as we head out to Arthur River. See the old Robin Gray, another plaque. This is Kuta Rocks, another little fishing community.
Multifaceted harbour.
Yeah.
Surfs up.
Have to pull your boat out of the water here during the strong winds. There's an Aboriginal midden, and there's cow manure, fishermen, big boats, strong wind. Lovely snorkeling spot. Through the Polaroid sunglasses. Great little snorkeling spot. I'll now remove the Polaroids. All these little hummocks are middens. four-wheel drivers drove all over them, just getting their way in into the huts here. On our way in, we saw the waves crashing on this rock. They look quite specky. Just sheltering behind a water tank on the hill.
These seagulls are fantastic.
Seagulls swooping everywhere on the wind up the little channel. Watching a whole bunch of Jonathan Livingston seagulls soaring on the wind. Stork. Come on, take off again. Nice little creek on the way up north to Stanley. Well, this is the edge of the world, it's called. At Arthur River. Gardiner Point, I think it was called. There's lots of logs washed down the Arthur River, come down the coast. Oh, there's the river meeting the ocean. There's the river going out.
surface. See that white bird in front of the wave breaking now?
Yeah.
It's quite big. It's got black wing tips. And it's diving quite high up.
Edge of the World. There's a little poem here by Brian Inder. I'm standing here casting a stone into eternity.
It's crossing the bridge at the river. Right. I got him right in the beginning.
The wind is blowing down the river.
That boat high and dry.
Milking time. Smell how the mist going out to West Point, an Aboriginal reserve anyway, and only a rough fact. So we're going out to Green Point. Might let the cows go first. Green Point near Marawa. This whole area might be Green Point rather than that point. Nice waves coming in.
Coming back from Green Point, and that could well be Cape Grim up there with Trefoil Island off it. I'm not too sure.
It's
just coming through an area that's got lots of silage being cut. Looks managed to me. It's got prunes. This is very damp country. Very pretty dairy.
There's a broken snag up on the top of that tree there. We're at Dismal Swamp. 6 o'clock or so after phoning home to Gillian. And this forestry reserve is all closed at 4. So they have a maze of some description at Dismal Swamp. There's a stump remaining from when they logged it in the old days, and they cut these steps in it. I've seen a number of these in the forest, but haven't had a photograph yet. That's the stump, and there's the tree that survived the loggers. Stanley, we camped last night. It blew a gale all night and flapped around in the nut here, or circular circular head. It was named by Bass and Flinders, and now it's sort of named the nut. And we're just looking at crayfish, and we're parked at the aquarium.
When they laid them.
So they're like chooks, there's stupid as well. Chooks will just keep sitting.
Yeah.
They missed his riz. They might wander up there a bit later. This is just to the west of the nut, Godfrey's Beach. We're at Highfield House. It gets its name from being high on a field and overlooks the circular hill.
Kitchen as you're going down there. But originally built the house, it was the headquarters for the Van Diemen's Land.
Yeah.
The wall going down. And presumably that was all.
Yeah, but by the time we got there, it was 4.5. That's
so
true.
The 8-year-old girl went to school, the 7-year-old boy, the 6-year-old boy.
So you best go back out to your donkey study down the room. Passage way here will take you upstairs 3 bedrooms, downstairs 2 cellars. And then you leave the big kitchen to last. You can actually exit out the back door here, which takes you down along beside the chapel, which has a schoolroom.
That's the chapel and the school room. very substantial stables. They have beautiful horses. They use some threshing machines. And these sheds.
You want me to read it out?